Follow actions are available in Session View. They're an automated way of triggering clips so that instead of looping or stopping, they can trigger another clip on the same track. They can be as simple as playing the next clip after a fixed amount of time, kind of like a mini DJ set, or as complex as creating infinitely evolving drum grooves or glitch effects with extreme randomization. They can be used in a live performance or in the studio as interesting sound design tools. In this video, I'll give you an overview of follow actions and demo a few of my favorite ways to use them. In this first example, let's keep things simple and just use two clips. These are drum loops playing different patterns. To reveal follow actions, you look down in clip view and click the triangle to show the clip launch settings. Then you can enable them by pressing the follow actions button so it turns yellow. Or if you're into keyboard shortcuts, you can select one or more clips and then press the shift and return keys to enable follow actions on all the selected clips. When a clip has a follow action enabled, you'll see the clip launch button changes style, and the next clip that's going to be triggered will flash. Now that we've got a feel for how this function works, let's amp things up and take a look at some more advanced uses. We've got a track here with a selection of different drum loops on it, with quite a bit of variation between them. Let's explore some of the ways they can be triggered. Follow actions are divided into follow action A and follow action B, so you can introduce some randomization with the follow action chance slider if you want. For now, we're just going to go with the default behavior of using 100% follow action A. The choices you have are pretty intuitive. You can have the clip stop. Play itself again. Play the previous or next clips. And play the first or last clips in the sequence. Any will randomly select the next clip to play from the entire group of clips on the track with follow actions engaged. This includes replaying the current clip. Other will play any other clip at random on the track. While jump allows you to select a specific clip to play next by selecting the number of the clip you want to trigger. It's important to note that clips will always launch according to their launch mode and quantization. Quantization is global by default, which you can change up here. But you can set individual quantization on clips for interesting stutter effects when in repeat mode. These clips all have different repeat quantizations, and that's particularly useful when using a MIDI controller or keyboard mapping. Now let's take a look at linked and unlinked follow actions. An unlinked action will play the clip for a specified follow action time and then carry out the next chosen action. When you use linked mode, it will play the clip for the full length set by the loop brace and then loop it the number of times you can set in the follow actions multiplier parameter before triggering the next clip. In our next example, we'll take a look at a musical loop. There's a series of clips all playing the same pattern, but with different synth sounds. I want to preserve the pattern, but switch up these sounds. When using a regular follow action, the next clip starts at the beginning. However, in this case, I want the next clip to come out where the first one left off. This is where legato mode is useful and does just that. Now let's use a glitch example. You can use randomization to divide between follow action A and follow action B, depending on the position of the follow action chance parameter. This allows you to create an evolving sequence that'll avoid repetitions and stay sounding fresh. If you want to take things to the next level, you can also use follow actions on entire scenes. This gives you a whole new world of creative possibilities for DJ sets and live performances.